Folks are still married? I do too. Stay tuned for another fun newlywed game chosen especially for you with me, Bob Eubanks.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple got happily hitched 13 months ago, Meredith and Joel Williams. Our next couple recited their vows 10 months ago, Shauna and Bob Batson. This couple traded rings 2 months ago, Laura and Richard Arnett. And our final couple celebrated their union 13 months ago, Sabrina and Dion Barnes. And now, here's the star of the newlywed game, Bob Eubanks!
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the newlywed game. Hey, you guys.
Hey.
Nice to have you here. Want to play the game?
Yeah.
Got a great honeymoon to give away. First of all, the ladies have to go off to the soundproof room. Would you please? Hey, gentlemen, in round one, I'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And the one couple with the most points, close your mouth there, Bob, at the end of the show, is going to win a fabulous second honeymoon. The ladies are gone. Here's your first question. You ready?
Lord.
Gentlemen, on the roadway of life, will your wife say your marriage has more U-turns, one-way streets, or dead ends? Dion?
Bob, I have to go with U-turns.
Your marriage got a lot of U-turns.
Yeah, in a way, every time we, you know, try to get something going, something always happens.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
I hear you. Bob!
Definitely U-turns, Bob.
No, you're Bob.
No, I'm Bob.
Yeah.
No, we were going to get married several times, so we always changed our
minds. Why not just get married once and forget it?
We were going to get married a couple of times, and we canceled it and kept going and canceled it, and so it's U-turns, definitely.
We Bobs are easy to confuse, aren't we?
Yeah, I surely am.
Joel!
I would have to say a one-way street.
It's a one-way street in your marriage.
As soon as we got married, or as soon as we met,
yeah,
we knew which way we were going.
This is it, boy. This is love. Yeah, okay. Richard.
Definitely dead end because
it's a dead end.
Well, because we were supposed to get married before we did, and it stopped, and we had not seen each other for 10 months, and it.
Supposed to get married before you did, so you stopped, didn't see each other for 10 months, but then you got back together and got married.
Yeah.
And it's still a dead end.
Well, whenever we argue.
I see, okay. Next question, gentlemen. If you could pick one of your wife's possessions to be ripped apart at the tractor pull, what will she say you would pick? Bob.
Prom pictures.
Prom pictures. Thank you. Joel.
Her paperwork, all her files.
Her files.
Yes.
Richard.
Her journal.
Her journal.
Yeah, she writes more in that than we talk.
So. You don't read it, do you?
Oh, no. No, I never read it.
Your nose is growing, Richard.
No.
Dion?
I have to go with the curling irons.
The old curling irons.
Tired of waiting on it, Bob. Tired of waiting on it.
There's nothing you can relate to, is it?
No. Not at all.
Next question, gentlemen. Of the following three, coffee, television, or sex, what will your wife say would be easiest to give up cold turkey for one entire month? And what would be the hardest to give up? Joel?
I'd have to say, would you say the easiest?
Yeah.
The easiest to give up, definitely television.
Television. Yes. What would be the hardest?
The hardest would be
coffee or sex?
Sex.
Sex, all right. What do you think, Richard? Easiest?
Coffee. She doesn't really drink coffee, so that'd be the easiest.
Okay.
And so sex would be the hardest.
So it's easy to give up coffee, hard to give up sex?
Yeah.
All right, fine. Dion, what would be the easiest?
Okay, it'd be easy for her to give up the coffee.
Coffee?
Hard to give up sex.
Sex.
Yeah.
All right, Bob, what do you think about this, Bob? What's easy to give up?
Coffee, definitely.
Coffee, what's the hardest?
I would say television.
Oh, man. Bob, you're making us Bobs look really bad. Thank you, gentlemen. We'll be right back to reunite these little ones. See how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Thank you.
I'm Bob Eubanks, and you're watching The Newlywed Game on Buzzer TV. Let's play.
Hey, welcome back to The Newlywed Game. Gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards and now have them in front of you. Each time your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins a great second honeymoon. So, ladies, nice to have you with us. Here's our first question. Ladies, on the roadway of life, would you say that your marriage has more U-turns, one-way streets, or dead ends? Laura?
I'd say dead end.
Why?
You don't want to know the story. We were engaged before, and then he dumped me a month before the wedding.
Oh,
so
wait a minute.
We got married.
He didn't tell it that way. He just said we didn't see each other.
No.
Wait a minute. He dumped you 1 month before the wedding?
Okay, but she dumped me 5 weeks before the wedding. So
but it wasn't real.
It was a fake breakup.
It was a wedding.
Why did you marry the sucker then? I mean, for crying out
loud. I missed him.
Oh, you missed him. Okay, good. That's
after
nice. I'm glad
son.
You married him. Otherwise, you'd have been here with some other loser.
Yeah, exactly.
Richard said your marriage is a dead end. Yeah, okay. Hey, Meredith.
Yeah.
Meredith, your marriage has been more U-turns, one-way streets, or dead ends?
One-way streets.
One-way streets. He predicted you would say it has been more one-way streets. Yes. Was it love at first sight?
Actually, it was. We met one day and been together ever since, eight years ago.
Wow. Isn't that nice? That's good. Shauna.
I'd have to say one-way street.
One-way street.
Because we get into arguments, we talk about resolutions, and it doesn't happen, so we just keep going down that path.
Yeah, keep going down that old one-way street. Bob said that, U-turns. U-turns.
What do you mean U-turns?
We were going to get married, and we kept changing our mind. I mean...
See?
Safrina.
Well,
what a pretty name, by the way.
Oh, thanks. I would have to say one-way street.
One-way street.
Yes.
All right. Your husband said it's been more like U-turns.
I mean, baby, not that I don't love you. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about, you know.
Hey, wait, every Dion, time we get why do you put your hand up like that? You afraid of it?
I'm trying to fend off with a pillow attack.
No, baby, don't hurt me.
Every time something going, something always happening that we have to start all over and stuff, you know what I'm saying?
She's got that pillow cock.
Well, he needs to start thinking about me and how I would answer the question, how he would answer the question.
Let's try another one, okay? Here we go. Ladies, if your husband could pick one of your possessions to be ripped apart at the tractor pull, what would he pick? Meredith?
Papers.
Papers. He said he would pick papers and files. Yes, okay. Shauna.
I think it would have to be some of my clothes.
Clothes, all right.
Yeah.
He said he would pick, no, your prom pictures.
Oh, he's so mad I kept my prom pictures.
She's with another guy in her prom pictures, and she keeps them still.
Wait a minute. Has she met you then?
No,
she hadn't met
you. Then why are you jealous of somebody when she hasn't even met you then?
I'm just over jealous, Bob.
Safrina.
Well, let's see. I would have to say my wardrobe, my clothes, and my shoes, because as soon as I walk in the door,
you're giving me about seven answers. How about wardrobe, clothes, shoes, jewelry, parents? Just give me one answer.
Let's stick with my clothes because
your clothes. He said he wants to rip apart your darn curling iron.
I don't say nothing about your clothes. You in the mirror all day long. I'm trying to go. You sitting up there messing with your hair. God.
Yeah.
Why do you always tell me, pick up your clothes, honey? Can you take your shoes upstairs, honey? As soon as I walk in the door, I'm stripping because I'm tired. I'm taking my own. No.
Way to go, Dion. Laura.
Probably my teddy bear, Melissa.
Your teddy bear, Melissa?
I've had her since I was five. So she's kind of raggedy now, and she's kind of, she's older and stuff.
Hey, careful with that older stuff. Okay. Richard said he'd like to rip apart your journal.
My journal?
Yeah, the one he reads all the time.
You know what's in there?
You don't tell me what you...
It's a journal.
Oh, you've read it.
We're keeping secrets already.
You've read it. It's not secrets.
You just have your own thoughts you need to keep to yourself.
Yes, that's right. Next question, ladies. Of the following three, coffee, television, or sex, what would you say would be the easiest to give up cold turkey for one entire month? And what would be the hardest? Coffee, television, or sex? What would be the easiest, Shauna?
Coffee.
What would be the hardest?
Coffee. Television.
Are you telling me he's not romantic?
No. I don't know.
You mean you'd rather watch television than have sex with Bob?
No, no.
That's what you said.
Okay, I want to change my answer.
No, you can't change your answer.
Man.
No, I'll tell you why. Because he says the same thing. Go be a television. Sabrina, what would be the easiest?
Coffee.
What would be the hardest?
Sex.
He said. Coffee and sex. You got it. Laura, what's the easiest?
Coffee.
What's the hardest?
Sex.
He said. Coffee and sex. Yeah. You got it. Meredith, easiest.
Coffee.
The hardest?
Television.
Yeah. No, he said the easiest would be television. The hardest would be sex. Ha ha. Yeah. We'll be back with the wives to see how well they predict us. Their husbands will say it right after these messages. Welcome back, everybody. Ladies, your husbands are all secluded off stage, and it's your turn to predict what they will say. Now, remember, these questions will be worth 10 points. So here's our first one. Ladies, what word will your husband say is uttered the most in your bedroom? Would that be yes, no, please, or sorry? Chana?
Please.
Please. Yeah. I know who that's from. Yeah. Meredith?
No.
No.
Not tonight, no.
Sorry. Laura?
No.
No.
Well, he's kind of busy.
Sabrina?
Ooh, I would have to say yes, Bob.
Yes.
Yes.
In the future, it would probably be best if you didn't say yes, Bob, though, okay? Thank you. Next question, ladies. If we could send off one part of your body to Hawaii for a vacation, which part will your husband say needs the most R&R? One part of your body. Meredith, we're going to send it off to Hawaii for a vacation.
My baby toe.
Your baby toe?
Huh?
Okay, whatever you say, Laura.
My hips.
Your hips are going to Hawaii for a vacation.
Probably a workout vacation.
Well,
but yeah.
did a little hula over there. Yeah. Sabrina?
I would have to say my stomach.
Your stomach
had a baby.
Going to Hawaii. Shauna?
My stomach, too.
Your stomach?
It's just, you know, not as small as I'd like it to be. So.
Well, I understand.
If it had a vacation, maybe it would do better.
All right. Well, ladies, here's our last of our 10-point questions. What will your husband say was the hair color of the last female who tried to nail him in a public place or at a party? Other than you. Hair color of the last female, Laura.
I'll say brunette, just because.
What color is that?
Brown.
Brown, thank you. Sabrina?
I would have to say black.
Black, okay. Shauna?
Brown.
Meredith?
Brown.
Brown, all right. 25-point bonus question, ladies. What will your husband say is the highest denomination bill in his wallet right now? Highest denomination bill in his wallet right now. Sabrina?
I would have to say a 20.
A 20. Shauna?
A 5.
A 5.
We haven't been to the bank.
Aren't we Bob something, though? Meredith?
A 20.
A 20. Laura?
A 20.
Yeah, great. 3 20s, and now Bob says 5. Ladies, we'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on a new episode.
Is the honeymoon over? More Newlyweds and Me, Bob Eubanks, coming up on Buzzer.
Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Two of our couples have 10 points, two of our couples have 5 points. And now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. And remember, these are the big questions. These are the 10-point questions. And here's our first one. Gentlemen, what word would you say is uttered the most in your bedroom? Would that be no, yes, sorry, or please? What word is uttered most in your bedroom, Joel? No, yes, sorry, or please?
No.
No.
Yeah, no. I get a no first. That's the first one. Then after no, then everything's all right.
So you say no, but then you say please. I see. Yeah. All right. So he said what word is uttered most in your bedroom is no. Yeah. Well, Bob, what do you think about this one?
Please. Because
Bobs don't say please.
It's true.
Bob say, hey, now! Shauna said it is, please, yes! Dion.
She don't get this one right, Bob. Got to be yes on
yes.
her part.
She said it's got to be, card please, yes! Yes. All right. Richard.
It's no.
It's no?
Yeah, I have to get up early in the morning, and I'm... That's, yeah, that's...
Well, you're a romantic guy, aren't you?
Oh, real romantic.
Yeah, I can tell. Wow. Okay, she said the it's no. All right. All right, next question, gentlemen. Hey, if we could send off one part of your wife's body to Hawaii for a vacation, which part would you say needs the most R&R? Which part do you think needs the most R&R here? Robert?
Probably her stomach.
Her stomach. All right. She said probably her stomach. Yeah. Hey, Dion, what do you think?
Only because you just had a baby. It got to be your stomach.
The old tummy. She said it's the old stomach. Yes. Okay. Richard.
Well, she complains about her hips, so...
Pardon me, sir?
She complains about her hips a lot, so I'm guessing her hips.
You think it's her hips? She predicted you would say it would be her hips. Yeah! Okay. You know what I've noticed? I've noticed that every time that he kisses you on the cheek.
Well, I gotta pay for it.
Not true. I don't know. I guess I just get excited.
You get excited when he kisses you on the cheek?
Maybe. No, I don't know.
Joe.
I would have to say her mind. She just finished her...
Her mind?
Oh. Yeah.
You're going to send her mind to Hawaii?
It needs to relax.
What's the matter with it?
She just finished a hard project, her dissertation, and she was very stressed out.
She's caught what?
She was very stressed.
Oh. Meredith said, you're going to send her baby toe off to Hawaii.
She needs to rest and relax.
Why? What's the matter with your baby toe?
That was sweet.
It's the nail is kind of curved into the side.
Really? Boy, I wish we had time to see that, but we don't. Darn. Next question. Gentlemen, what would you say was the hair color of the last female who tried to nail you in a public place or at a party? This is other than your wife. Hair color, Dion, of the last female that tried to nail you at a public place or a party other than your wife?
I just have to say black.
Black, all right. She predicted you would say black. You got it. Yeah.
Hey, Bob.
Hey, last female that tried to nail you in a public place or at a party. What color hair does she have?
Brown.
Brown. She said brown. Yeah.
I don't know of anybody yet, sir.
Hey, Joel, what do you think?
I'm going to say blonde or brown. No, brown.
Kind of which one are you going to say?
It's kind of dishwater blonde or brown.
No, you give me two answers. Pick an answer.
Brown.
Thank you very much. She said yes! Brown. Yeah. Who was this girl?
Well, we were eating the other day, and somebody was... We noticed someone was staring across the table.
A young one.
A young one?
I was eating.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Yeah, I was eating. That's it.
Giving you the old...
Yes.
Yeah. Wow. You devil, you.
See, I didn't even notice her hair color, see?
Yeah, right. I noticed. Hey, Bob. Last time some female tried to nail you in a public place, how long ago was that, Bob?
A long time ago.
I see. What color hair does she have?
Brown.
Brown. Your wife said brown. All right. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer.
You're going to Antigua. You'll stay at the famous St. James Club in Antigua, an idyllic all-inclusive resort boasting beaches, water sports, tennis, entertainment, and more. The St. James Club Antigua. Have a fabulous second honeymoon. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, John, very much. All right, couples, here it is, our 25-point bonus question. For 25 points, what's the highest denomination bill in your wallet right now? Couple number two, Joel and Meredith with 30. 25 would give you, look at all the points these couples have. 25 would give you 55. What's your answer here, Joel?
$20.
20. She predicted you would say it's a 20. Yeah. Couple number three, Bob and Shauna with 35. 25 would give you a grand total of 60. Bob, you know, this trip is in Antigua. Have you ever been there?
No, I haven't.
Where is it?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. What's your answer?
10.
10. She said, you're not going anyway. 5. Oh, honey. Couple number four, Deanna and Safrina. You have 35. 25 will give you a grand total of 60. Get it right, and you'll be in first place.
20.
20. She said 20. Yes. All right. Couple number one, Richard and Laura. You have 40. 25 will give you a grand total of 65 points. If you get it right, you and your wife win a fabulous trip to Antigua. And you can take Bob with you because he knows how to get there.
Actually, I think I want a credit card, so I'm going to give a zero.
Zero. No, really? She said you have a 20. Means a couple number four. Deanna and Sabrina. You're our Newlywed Game grand prize winners. Congratulations. Thank you, all of our couples. Thank you at home. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Hi there, it's Bob Eubanks again. Hey, here's